Now let me explain that. Before that, I'll explain about the author, okay? Subrata Bagchi, right? Subrata Bagchi is the founder of CEO, founder and CEO of Mintree. Founder and CEO of Mintree. Once he was the chief guest for the International Academy for Creative Teaching, Bangalore, on January 6, 2005, where he gave an inspirational speech on the convocation day for the graduating teachers. Here, he said, "I and me everywhere, but it was meant for all the human beings and the students who are going to be taught as they are our future generations." In the same way, he and him in the explanation is about society and the social beings living in it along with the students. He appeals the teachers who are graduating that year to teach the students beyond their syllabus, such as the values of life and the skills to live and develop themselves, which helps them to understand that their life should be useful and meaningful. Here, let me explain this. And he said it a great day for teachers. Teachers are graduating in 2005. And the administration and faculties who are giving another set of good teachers to the world. Since they are teachers, they are going to inspire and teach the coming generations. And he said he was honored to be there on the graduating day occasion of the teachers, as he is sharing their happiness and dreams. He wanted to ask the graduating teachers a few things on behalf of students who are going to be taught by them. He said that he is not going to ask the usual questions, but something different. And convocation. Here, convocation means a large formal assembly of people in a university or a college. Convocation means a large formal assembly of people in a university or a college. And then proportionately means in a way that corresponds in amount to something else. And then honored means regarded with respect. And then first I pray to you that you teach me the value of inclusion. See here, let me read. The people who write my textbooks and the ones who prescribe the syllabi will not tell you how important inclusion is for me to do well in life. Without the sense of inclusion, I will not know that boundaries are meant to be pushed, not to be lived in. And then, take for example the fact that I clean my house but empty my garbage on the road. That is because the road is not included in what I feel in my own. I feel my own child, but do not ask if the maid has eaten today. Her hunger is not included in my hunger. I take my child to the movie, but do not ask him to call the neighbor's child. That child is outside my zone of parenting. So, teacher, teach me inclusion. Let me explain this. Yes. First of all, Subrata asked the teachers to teach them the importance of inclusion, right? He said the people who write the syllabus or the textbook do not explain the importance of inclusion in life. When the teachers teach them the importance of inclusion, then the students can understand that there are no fixed boundaries to limit themselves and instead go beyond it. He gave a few examples of inclusion. First one is, he gave examples, right? Subrata said that he generally cleans house but puts the garbage on the roads because he feels that roads are not his. His house is his and he should always keep it neat and clean. He need not bother about the roads. And he makes sure that his children are not going hungry and feed them regularly. But he doesn't even ask his servants or maids whether they have eaten or not. This is because their hunger is not very important for him and he doesn't bother about them. And he makes sure his children enjoy. So he takes them to movies for entertainment, but he don't think of his neighbor's kid who cannot afford all this entertainment. Okay, just because the child is not his and is not included in his parenting, he doesn't take care of them. So he asked the teachers to teach the importance of inclusion in our day-to-day life to care for everyone. The difficulty words. Prescribe, advise. Prescribe means advice. Prescribe, advice. And syllabi. Syllabi means plural form of syllabus. Syllabi means plural form of syllabus. A syllabi here, right? Prescribe means advice. And syllabi means plural form of syllabus. Plural form of syllabus. And then included. Contained as part of a whole being considered. Included means contained. Contained as part of a whole being considered. Yes. Next. I pray to you to teach me to communicate. I pray to you to teach me to communicate. Let me read. As I get caught in the rat race of the common entrance test and cutthroat competition, everyone will tell me that my survival depends on my power to impress. To more, I want to impress. I less, I will communicate. Teach me to speak and be able to write so that I am able to convey what I feel. Teach me to communicate with the simplicity of a child and the nakedness of a flower. Those who cannot speak or hear, people less gifted, less privileged than I am. Those who have come before me and those who will follow. Things animate and inanimate. I pray to you to make me learn more than that. Teacher, teach me how I can learn to learn. Learn to learn. See, as you prepare me for the wide world in which I need to fend for myself and for others, one time learning will not be good enough. I will have to have the ability to learn never and more difficult things. Some of it I will need to learn very quickly. In all this, what will become critical is the process of learning itself, more than just what I am able to learn. Help me to learn newer ways to learn, and that will make learning a joy for me. Yes, let me explain. He's requested to teach them how to communicate with each other. How to communicate with each other. He says he doesn't want to talk for the sake of talking, but he wants to communicate. In this world of competition, wherein as the students grow, they have to write many entrance tests, and these tests will decide their fate. Unless and until students get good scores or ranks in the test, they are not eligible for anything. The world is so involved in impressing but forgetting about expressing. So he wants the teacher to make the students communicate what they feel, as they are not possible to put it on paper whatever they need to communicate, right? He says to teach communicate like a small child who doesn't understand how to manipulate the speech, right? Like a flower who has no artificial thing in it. He wants to talk to those who cannot speak or hear, like deaf and dumb, and send messages to them. He wants to communicate with people who have fewer facilities. He wants to communicate with who is older than him and who is going to be with him forever. He wants to communicate with both living and non-living things. And he wants children to be taught the process of learning. And then he says that as the children grow up, they have to take care of themselves and the people around them. So learning once is not enough. They have to learn every time a new thing to keep in pace with the world and take care of themselves and their family. And then the students have to learn new things every time, and sometimes even they have to learn very quickly. So the entire process of learning itself will become difficult. He says the students need help to learn new things, and the process of learning should be enjoyable. Here, difficulty words means communicate. Here, first one is communicate. Communicate means share or exchange information, news or ideas, learn, gain or acquire knowledge, competition, an event or an exam in which people take part in order to establish superiority or supremacy in a particular area. Okay, students, are you all understood? And this passage? Yes, you have to read it again and you have to memorize the glossaries, right? I'll read it. Syllabi, plural of syllabus. Inclusion, all people being valued irrespective or of differences. Cutthroat, competitive. less privileged, disadvantaged, animate, living, fend, look after, critical, extremely important. Okay, students, let me continue in the next class. You have to read the passage well. Okay, students, thank you. Keep safe at your home. Thank you, students.